I'm going to put them up here so that I can remember where to look in the camera. And I have no idea what I'm doing here today. What do you want me to draw? I don't have anything to draw on. This won't be too interesting. I think I should try to do that painting all over again. I don't have the right board with me. In this photograph, right? And I'm going to put the tracing of the line copies underneath. And I bet you I won't be able to see a thing. Phew. Now, of course, I was not expecting to do this at all. So everything I need is in the other room. And I'll need to put this here. This means, am I serious? I'm going to try to paint over this. This is wacky. To keep it together. So, okay, here's what I'm gonna really, really, really cheat. It's not gonna be clean. There we go. It's gonna get a few basics in here. I don't have my lightweight board in here. So I don't know that I can hold Masonite up by hand. You can't see this. Just have to see it enough so I can see it. There's a kite in here along this roof. Line. That's me digging on the lamp. Or you can say it's a bellboy. Out in the water. Ding. Ding. Okay, let's see what happens. Wait, wait, wait. I just came here with the intention of figuring out just what went wrong the other day. And why it wasn't recording. I'm still not quite sure, but at least I learned some other things about it. Okay. And we're just going to see if we can make this. Into a very simple picture. There. I'm sure you can't. You see some kind of vague tracing, right? clip-on. Let's hope there's still paint in the palette, but it's not all used up. And I still need that for reference. Paint water, still dirty. Let me show this back. Brush. At this time, I'm going to start with the sky. That way, I don't have to worry about making a choice because it will already be done. And I just noticed that I have a tiny dab of some paint. The color, I have no idea what color it is. I think it's cobalt turquoise. That one the students gave me a while back. Such a small dab. And I'm going to do this now. Remember, you shouldn't be painting vertically with watercolor. Where's it going to go? Down. Unless you are so good at not being dribbly. Usually you like to be dribbly. And since I'm not good at painting a smooth wash, I think it's important too. At least have some kind of rhythm in your strokes. Not that I can really say that these have rhythm. You should at least be paying attention to it. Or like watching the paint come out. Okay. There's so much stuff on this messy table. I can't push the camera back further, but the laptop, that's where my camera is. I only hope that I grew my vertical. I'm going to go darker on those in a second, but what can I do to make a bricky color? I've got some ready red and a little bit. bit of brown. Let's see how that comes up. Now, go back into that ready red. This with some purple in the red. You can see this somewhat. Okay, let's do that over here too. And I'm going to put the cap on the lighthouse right now. So I think this is phthalo green under all this color. And with some purple, you get something that's good and dark. Maybe too dark. This needs to come out a little bit more. We can use some of that dark color, but a little more water in it. I suppose I could have set up an easel. I mean, if I can paint vertically on this, holding it. And I could do it at an easel, couldn't I? So here's some yellow and that purple. Look at the front side of the foundation or whatever you call it. It's under the light. Sort of tan orangey color going here. And I need to paint under where my palette. You don't need to see the palette, do you? You just need to see the painting. This is too heavy to hold. Okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of roof up there. was not too distorted. Yeah, dark there. But now I'm guessing with it. Door is right under that middle window. Little window. Not really. Okay. I forgot the white trim under there. Some kind of window there. And I know how to get that white trim in there. This needs to be a dark roof. It's okay. For now, we'll find out later. Some purpley and that phthalo green. And now this is confusing me. The lands, the actual breakwater stuff. Yes, that should be actually quite straight where it can be wavy where it meets the water. Yes, we know there are huge swells in the water. And it cuts back a little bit. Okay. Now, I want some kind of reflect. The water's broken up. So the reflection is only, it's not distinct. You just see darker areas. And that's too pure of a color. Okay, I'm just gonna put that on. See what happens if I put it slightly orangey red in there. It's too brown. Use that orangey red with blue. Leave some gaps. Cobalt. And then move on to more cobalt with some of the leftover paint from that wash. And I've touched, so that's all. I didn't mean to, but it's all going to run in there. A lot of this is physics. What is the water and the pigment going to do? And in that way, it's a lot like cooking. What is the action of heat? Or various pans going to do when the various kinds of foods meet? That's three dark areas to do there, and then I want it. Before that, I want to get these mountains and big mountains. It's nice and smoky. Move on now. Oh, I can just see I went into an area I don't want to. Now here's where I have to be careful, because in my position, that vertical might tend to lean too much. I'm going to bring a similar color for that patch of water there. Maybe there'll be a little more blue in it. It used to be pale still. Since you don't see ins and out of land, all you see is water vapor. And I hope it is straight across, because I can't tell from here. Turning out to be a very lavender scene, I think. And there's a dark area there, but I don't gotta be careful. I'm gonna make this thing dark. Let me wait with that. I'll get those darks right now. Some purple and some red. Use it for the chimney. And it's too red. Okay, I think we got that. A little bit. Let's get darker here. Know what that means. Okay, I'm gonna have to dig in and do that piece of land now. Green and purple. It is dark, I hope it's not. Too dark. That's about to break. So I'm not gonna mop it up, I'm gonna try to reach it up. Any more dribblers? Anything that's really gonna break barriers. And be careful because one of those big beads of paint and water can leave its own mark or imprint of whatever the material is made of. We don't want to have an imprint of a paper bounty paper towel from there. I don't think you do. I don't. That's why I don't use them. I use soft t-shirts. Even that has a print. So be careful what you scoop up. And that's kind of dark. I don't want it that dark. So as soon as I've gotten it in, I'm going to print, damp it. Okay. I'm going to write on here what it is, and I'll see I can do it without too much of a slant. And I'll try to write smaller so I can get my name on there. Nothing. Not a good brush to write there. Try to use the little corner. Right. I'm going to be eager. See if I'm going to get my name in. I'm heading right into wet territory. Not gonna shut. which means it'll run. And 8, 27, 1, 7. Am I missing anything? I'll throw a little orange in there, orangey. Okay. What did I not get in there? Oh, I think some indication that that is not still water. It's out there, you can't really. And there's a little patch of green flatlands right here. But I'm not there. I'm not sure how crazy I am about a turquoise sky there. It's off the brush. So it'll be too stiff when I come back to it. And here we are, Katinka Studio. KatinkaCards.com. See you the next time. Bye. Stop the broadcast.